The Busia District National Resistance Movement NRM Party youth leaders have vowed to reclaim the party position in the coming general elections since its place was taken over by the opposition parties during the 2021 elections. In the 2021 elections, President Yoweri Museveni garnered 44,679 votes, accounting for 46%. Robert Kyagulanyi of NUP Party got 45,166, standing for 47%, and Amuriat Oboi Patrick of FDC got 2,671. The concerns were raised during the district NRM party youth leaders meeting held in Busia over the weekend. Benessa Adrian, the NRM Busia district youth chairperson, admitted the poor party performance in 2021 elections and said that they have resolved on reforms that shall aid in regaining the victory of the NRM party.
There could have been some shortcomings that may have affected our performance in the previous elections, but we have all accepted to bear our hatchets as party leaders and see to it that we intensively mobilize for the forthcoming independence celebrations here.
Wasike Hamed Chigenyi, the Busia Municipality Youth Chairperson, attributed the poor performance of the ruling party in the previous elections to internal conflicts amongst the district leadership, an issue he said has been resolved.
The biggest problem was in the internal system of the party here at the district level. We realized that the structure leadership had issues here and there. One, that the structures were torn by flag bearers.
Auma Irene, the district youth female councillor, outlined the challenge of corruption and discrimination in the job opportunities, which she says impedes supporting the ruling party.
Corruption has denied so many opportunities to get services which they would have got, because when you look at Busia district, more so when it comes to service deliveries like opening of roads, we are doing badly.
Kenyan President William Ruto landed in Port-au-Prince and met Kenyan soldiers deployed in Haiti as members of the multinational force that has come to tackle the wave of violence sweeping the Caribbean country. Ruto stepped off the plane, walking past armed officers on a small patch of red carpet, flanked by other officials. He headed to a Kenyan base at the airport, where he met with the police tasked with battling the gangs and several high-ranking Haitian and Canadian officials.
Emmanueli, ameni tendea, ameni tendea, ameni tendea, ameni tendea.
He claimed that Kenyan forces have boosted security infrastructure and allowed displaced Haitians to return home after fleeing violence, though many Haitians say violence is just as bad, if not worse, than it was when the police were deployed in June.
Today there is a lot more confidence that the job of stabilizing Haiti, of dealing with gangs in Haiti and violence, and making sure that we free the people of Haiti from this yoke of underdevelopment occasioned by violence.
Kenya was the first nation to send forces as part of a larger effort by the UN to offer international support to Haiti, which has spiraled into conflict and political turmoil since the 2021 assassination of President Jovenel Moise. About 400 Kenyan police are in Haiti. Earlier this month, about 24 police and soldiers from Jamaica arrived in the country. But the United States and other countries have said that the forces aren't enough and lack resources to take on the gangs, which control about 80% of the capital, Port-au-Prince. As Ebola supporters in Lebanon turned out yesterday in force for the funeral of a top commander, Ibrahim Akil, who was killed in an Israeli airstrike in Beirut's southern suburbs in a major show of support for the Iran-backed group. Hezbollah has hailed Commander Ibrahim Akil as one of its great leaders, saying the 61-year-old died in an Israeli assassination in Beirut's southern suburbs on Friday. Akil aided Hezbollah's elite Radwan unit and had been on U.S. sanctions list for nearly a decade. Israel said Friday's targeted strike killed Akil and several other commanders in the Radwan force. Men and women, many wearing black, gathered for the packed ceremony in the southern suburbs of Lebanese capital, where Hezbollah enjoys steadfast support. Many mourners carried photos of Hezbollah members who had been killed. Fighters in fatigues and red berets lined up while others carried Akil's coffin and that of another Hezbollah member, both covered in the group's yellow flag as a brass band played. Security was tight with the immediate area surrounded by metal fencing.